Welcome to my channel Immigrate Abroad. I am Sunil Raj and today I'll be showing you how to find out if your skills are in demand in Canada. I recently made a video on top 10 in demand jobs in Canada, and while researching for that topic on blogs, forums and videos, I came across a lot of comments from people asking if their skill set is in demand in Canada. And obviously there are a lot more than just 10 in demand jobs in Canada. I decided to make this video so you don't have to wonder if your skills are in demand or not. I'll also share with you what to do if your skills are not in demand in Canada, so stay tuned. All links mentioned in this video will be in the description below. Let me first show you how to research on jobs. There are plenty of Canadian job sites like Monster, Workopolis, Career Builder, Indeed, LinkedIn, Glassdoor, and a few other. But Indeed Canada has always worked out for me. What I'm about to show you will work out with any of the job sites you prefer. Usually, while searching for jobs, we tend to look up either our current designation or job title. Depending on where you are from, the job title in your country can be different from the one in Canada. Don't expect the job titles to be the same, and instead search with skill sets you have. For example, say someone's looking to check if statistician jobs are in demand in Canada. If you search with the job title, you can find a few jobs and they are scattered across the province. They are all over and there are very few, and in total there are only 83 jobs. Now, if you do a job search based on the skill set, all statisticians use some tools to perform their analysis like SPSS, Statistica, or the R project tool, etc. And if I search with the keyword SPSS, I'll find more results than before with a different keyword, which shows there is a demand for statisticians, but not very high demand. This way, you can also identify in which province or city there are more opportunities. In total, across Canada, there are 262 jobs. When you're doing this search, don't enter a province or the city name. So make sure that way you can identify which locations have the most number of opportunities available. This can also help you determine which city or province you should immigrate to or where you should move to. Once you find the job that matches your skill, bookmark them. You might end up with several of them, so bookmark them to a folder. Closely monitor these job posts daily to check how long they are posted on the job sites. Some companies will remove the jobs once they find a suitable candidate, or usually after 30 days, and repost the job if they haven't found a candidate. The number of jobs available each month, frequency of job postings, deletion, and reposting will give you an idea if your skills are in demand. In my case, even before I submitted my Express Entry profile, I started to research for jobs to find out if my skills are in demand or not, what new skills I might have to acquire, or what employers are looking for in my area of work. So here's the thumb rule. Once you narrow down your job search, if you have 100 plus jobs available that match your skill set and the jobs stay on the site for 30 days or more, then your skill set is in demand. If it doesn't stay on the site for 30 days or more, say jobs were posted and a week after they are removed, then it means there is competition for your skill set. Employers are able to find candidates quickly. Similarly, if you have 200 plus jobs available that match your skill set, then your skill set is in high demand. If the jobs are reposted after 30 days and they are removed after 60 or 90 days, then it means there is less competition for your skill set. Employers are unable to find candidates quickly. In another scenario, if you have 300 plus jobs available that match your skill set, then your skill set is in very high demand. if the job posts are reposted and they are removed after 90 or 120 days, then it means there is no competition for your skill set. When I was researching, jobs were reposted for 6 months and they were unable to find candidates in my area. I knew my skill set was in high demand and I had less competition. I was able to land a job within a month of moving to Canada. Now, what to do if your skills are not in demand or if you find less than 50 openings across Canada? I just want to make it clear, nothing is impossible, and if you are a good candidate, you will land a job even if you have less than 10 opportunities. However, you might have to wait a bit longer sometimes and have to make every opportunity count to land a job if opportunities are less in your area of expertise. Do your research well, and if you find less or no opportunities in Canada, look for options where you can transfer your skill set to another area that is in demand. What new skills and experiences can you learn to fall into the in-demand category and work on gaining experience in that area, either by self-learning, certification, or work experience? So there you have it. How to check if your skills are in demand in Canada. I hope this video was helpful. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, share this video, and comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to receive notifications on upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.